The first gift was from Mrs. Maria Soames in 1851. She was persuaded by the bishop-designate Thomas Jackson to buy a land order in memory of her late husband Joseph Soames and present it to college to provide scholarships for the school. When the draw was made, Mrs. Soames' land order turned out to be section number one, or first choice of land in the Canterbury settlement, a prime town section in Littleton, and 50 acres of rural land on the outskirts of the port were chosen. The Soames estate subsequently endowed the Soames scholarships, which have been awarded annually ever since, giving generations of boys the benefit from a college education. Maria took a great interest in the Soames scholars, which numbered 15 when she died, aged 95, in July 1911. She is considered college's first and greatest benefactor. In 1863, Big School was built following a grant of £1,000 from the Canterbury Provincial Council. It was designed by James Edward Fitzgerald, Canterbury's superintendent and fellow of the college. In its time, Big School has had a number of roles, initially as classrooms, then as the assembly and concert hall, and today, after additions and alterations by Warren and Marnie in the 1990s, it is used as a school library. On the 23rd of May 1853, Henry Sewell, who was instrumental in establishing college on its present site, wrote in his diary, "A college without a chapel is like a play without Hamlet." Later, Henry John Chitty Harper, Bishop of Christchurch and Warden of College, went about raising funds where he could. In January 1866, he announced to the board he had raised £500 in England, a significant portion of the £708 needed to build the chapel. The chapel was opened on the 23rd of October 1867. In a glowing editorial in the press, it was described as an admirable modern example of what a school chapel should be. The building presents a massive and honest appearance both in design and construction. The chapel was not consecrated until a year later, when Bishop Harper returned from the Lambeth Conference in England. In 1873, the Synod Hall, offices, library and lecture room were built. They were designed by Dr. Alfred Charles Barker, amateur architect and fellow of college. The offices were to be used by college and the church. The provincial government granted college £1,700 to help with the build of the new lecture room and library, because they were also to be used by the Canterbury Collegiate Union, which consisted of the museum, Canterbury College and the public library. Bequests are a valuable way to leave a legacy to college. During 1886 to 1888, an organ chamber was added to the chapel, paid for by a bequest from one of college's first fellows, William John Warburton Hamilton. Hamilton was a fellow from 1855 until his death in 1883. Many turned out for the opening of the organ chamber in 1888. It had been a busy 50 years, and by 1900, with 209 boys enrolled, college was very much a part of and established in the Christchurch community. An exciting future beckoned.